Greetings, my dear students. Today I'd like to discuss with you another case study of the multiple growth model. In the previous session, we have discussed about the multiple growth model, and today let's go through another case study with some more adjustments. Okay, so the question is, the company pays dividend of rupees 2 and the dividend is expected to grow at the rate of 15% annually for the first 3 years and 12% rate for the next 3 years. Okay, after which it is expected to grow at 5% forever. What value would you place on equity share if 9% rate of return is required? And another question is, would your calculation change if you expect to hold this share only for 3 years? Okay, so here the growth rate is 15% for the first 3 years, and then it is 12% for another 3 years, and afterwards it is 5% forever. Okay, so we can divide the time period into two. First time period is supernormal period and then second period is normal period. That is, supernormal period is 6 years. In supernormal period, first 3 years dividend is growing at 15%, and in the next 3 years dividend is growing at 12%. Okay, so there are two growth rate in the supernormal period, and afterwards the constant growth period or in the normal period the growth rate is 5%, and K is 9% here. And we know the equation. If the growth rate is different, we can apply multiple growth rate model. And the equation for calculating intrinsic value is V0 is equal to V1 plus V2. And V1 means the present value of dividends in the supernormal period, and V2 is the present value of dividends in the constant growth period. Okay, so let us calculate. Firstly, we can calculate V1, and for calculating V1, we need to calculate the dividend first. Okay, dividend is growing at 15% in first year. Our present dividend, current dividend, that is D0 is equal to 2, that is mentioned in the question. And for calculating D1, D0 into 115%, because dividend is growing at 15% in the first year. So we need to add 15% with 2. 2 plus 2 into 15 by 100. That's equal to 2 into 115 by 100. Okay. So 2 into 115 divided by 100, 2.3 is the dividend in the first year. And in the second year, 2.3 into 100, this is D1 into 115 by 100. That's equal to 2.645. That is the dividend in the second year. And in the third year, dividend is 2.645 into 115 divided by 100. That is dividend in the second year, D2 into 115 by 100. That is equal to 3.004175. Okay. And in the fourth year, and afterwards, and in the first 3 years, dividend is growing at 3%. And in the second next 3 years, dividend is growing at 12%. So here onwards, after 3 years, we have to calculate, we have to add 12% with the dividend. Okay, so in the fourth year, dividend is 3.410418 into 112 divided by 100. That's equal to 3.4068. That is the dividend in the fourth year. And in the fifth year, 3.4068, that is D4 into 112 divided by 100, then we'll get 3.8156. that is the dividend in fifth year. And D6 is equal to D5 into 112 divided by 100. That's equal to 4.2734. here we are applying two growth rates, because in the first 3 years, in the supernormal period, in the first 3 years there is 15% growth rate, and in the next 3 years there is 12% growth rate in dividend. Okay, so now for calculating V1 means present value of dividend in the supernormal growth period. So we need to calculate the present values of dividend. For that, we here provided four columns. In the first column, we are writing year in the first column, and in the second column, dividend, in the third column, present value at the rate of 9%. K is equal to 9 in the question, and the present value factor at 9% for first year is 0.9174. So 0.9174 into 2.3, we will get present value of dividend in the first year, that is 2.1100. Then dividend present value of dividend in the second year is equal to present value factor at the rate of 9% in the second year is 0.8417. That we will get from our present value factor table. Then we are multiplying this present value factor at 9% in second year with second year's dividend 2.645, then we will get present value of dividend in the second year, that is 2.2263. Then likewise, we can determine the different present value factors at 9% for different years, third year, fourth year, fifth year and sixth year, and we are multiplying the corresponding dividend with it, and then we will get present values of each year's dividend, and by totaling this we will get V1. That's equal to 14.1265. That is the present value of dividends in the supernormal period. Okay, now we need to calculate V2. V2 means present value of P6, because here the end of the supernormal period is sixth year. So the P6, a present value of P6 is the V2, as we already discussed in the previous session. And P6 is equal to, we know the equation for calculating P0 as D0 into 1 plus G divided by K minus G as per constant growth method. So here P6 is equal to D6 into 1 plus G divided by K minus G. D6 is here. D6 is 4.2734. Then 4.2734 into 1 plus, here in the normal growth period, the growth rate is 5%. That is here in the question. So D6, that's equal to 4.2734 into 1 plus growth rate is 5%, 1 plus 0.05, divided by K minus G. K is 9%, so 0.09 minus G is equal to 5%, so 0.05. Okay, then we'll get 4.48707 divided by 0.04. Then V2 is equal to 112.177. Okay, so now we can easily apply this all these aspects in our equation for calculating intrinsic value. Equation for calculating intrinsic value is, sorry, before that, this is P6, and now we need to calculate present value of P6 for calculating V2. So P6 into present value factor at 9% for 6 years. Present value factor at 9% in 6th year is 0.5963, and we are multiplying 112.177, that is P6, with it. Then we will get present value of P6 as 66.89. Okay, now we can easily calculate the intrinsic value by adding V1 plus V2. Then V1 is equal to 14.1265 plus V2 is equal to 66.89. Then we will get P0 as 81.0165. Okay, the second aspect of our question is, the intrinsic value of the second aspect of our question is that would your calculation change if you expect to hold this share only for 3 years? Is there any change in your calculations, or if there is any change in the if you expect to hold this share only for 3 years, if we are holding this share only for 3 years, what will be the intrinsic value? What will be the calculation for intrinsic value? That is what asked in this question. So let us check what sort of changes we can made to the calculations. Okay, that is we know that we have given in dividend growth models, the holding period is not given as per one of the assumption of a dividend growth model is that dividend holding period is not given. Holding period is not given. So in the second aspect of our question, that is asked that whether if we are holding it for 3 years, so the holding period is mentioned. For mentioning the, if the holding period is mentioned, we can apply either single period model or multi-period model. As per single period model is only for in the case of single period model, holding period is only 1 year, and in the case of multi-period model, holding period will be different number of years. So here 3 years are the holding period, and we can apply the multi-period model here. Okay, if the holding period is mentioned, we can apply multi-period model. The equation for calculating intrinsic value as per multi-period model is equal to V0 into D1, P0 is equal to D1 divided by 1 plus k raised to 1 plus D2 divided by 1 plus k raised to 2 plus etc. Dn divided by 1 plus k raised to n plus Pn divided by 1 plus k raised to n. That is present value of D1 plus present value of D2 plus present value of etc. present value of Dn plus present value of Pn. That is at the end of the holding period, we will sell that share, then we will get an amount, that is Pn. Then the selling price of the share at the end of the holding period is Pn. This method is discussed, we have discussed this method in the previous sessions. So let us calculate the present values of all dividends. Here 3 years are mentioned. We have calculated the present values of dividends for 3 years as 2. First, in the first year, the present value of dividend is 2.1100. In the second year, present value of dividend is 2.2263. And in the third year, the present value of dividend is 2.3488. Okay, so we have calculated present values of dividends. These present values of dividends plus present value of the selling price is the intrinsic value as per multi-period model. Okay, have you got it? Okay, so here we are calculating the intrinsic value by applying the equation P0 is equal to D1 into present value factor at 9% for first year plus D2 into present value factor 9% in the second year plus D3 into present value factor at 9% in the third year plus P3, that is the selling price at the end of the third year, into present value factor at 9% for third year. Okay, then we will get, we have already calculated the present values of dividends. The total is, that is, those are 2.2263 plus 2.3488. Then the total of these three will be 6.685. We need to add present value of selling price with it. Okay, then we will get intrinsic value of the share if the holding period is 3 years. Okay, this is the calculation, but in the question, present value of selling price is not given. So we can just mention the method of calculation here, and you need to calculate this question's intrinsic value of this assignment. Okay, thank you.